Welcome to our continuing series of interviews with international business leaders discussing the impact of the coronavirus crisis. The COVID-19 pandemic has closed borders and restricted travel all across the world. So how do companies with significant international operations respond to this new situation? Today, we discuss a company with international operations across Central and Eastern Europe, but also China, India, Vietnam, Philippines, and Indonesia. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Renata Mrazova. Renata is based in Prague, and she's the Chief People Officer of the consumer finance company Home Credit International.
I think it's a very interesting question because Home Credit is on more markets, and we have business in China. So we have been dealing with coronavirus already since January in the business of China. And then, of course, as of mid of March, we have seen all different kinds of lockdowns in all our markets where we are. It's multiple effects on the organization. So we have a total of 125,000 employees globally. And as I said, the majority of our business is in Asia, but we have also business in Czech, Slovak, Russia, and also US. I think this situation, because it really brings a lot of volatility, uncertainty, no one knows what will be happening. It brings actually a lot of emotions. And I think people feel anxious, people feel lonely, isolated. And despite the fact that we have technology, which is replacing the communication, it does not fully replicate the face-to-face interactions, which brings a lot of energy, feeling bonded, connected. So I see a lot of emotions, a lot of up and downs of different people. And my advice is actually that it's very important just to accept it. I think important is that we share it and that we support the people, who struggle with it. I think it really requires even stronger emotional intelligence that you connect with the people, you create trustful environment that people do not hesitate to share with you some of their concerns, worries. I think the most important, the company, the leadership, the managers, we need to show the understanding and the big support. And I think if people are able to do that, I see magic happening, so more empathy, more care, more intense communication, showing, that we are here for you to support. And I think we will all handle it quite well. I think with every change, there is never going back to the normal, which was, before the change. So I don't call it a crisis. I think it's a big change, very complex change for everyone, which is always difficult to handle, difficult to manage. So I believe it brings a lot of opportunities because it pushes all of us to think in different way, to think us about different business models, different ways of working. I would actually mention probably three areas which for me are crucial. The first one we already talked about, it's the overall digitalization and moving to online business models. I think this is significant and it's quite exciting to see what's happening and how it is very naturally shifting in that direction. The second is we can call it agile way of working. This crisis which brings uncertainty that we don't know what the situation will be tomorrow, in 1 week, in 1 month, it really pushes us to very adaptive leadership style. And the third, which is connected to the people, I think the people focus combination of left brain capabilities with right brain capabilities, really pushing strong interest, care, empathy, connection, talking with people, showing the vulnerability, creating the trust. These are the most critical leadership skills which will help the companies to be long-term successful.